Hello, friends. My name is Brittany Timberlake. Welcome to a restorative yoga practice. This practice is designed for anyone experiencing menstrual cramps or anyone who is experiencing abdominal bloating or discomfort from fertility treatments such as Clomid, Letrozole, or IVF. Not only will this practice help alleviate some of the physical discomfort that you might be experiencing, but also allowing you to hold this safe space to watch and observe any emotional pain that you might be going through as well. For this practice, it would be nice if you had a lot of blankets. I have one blanket laid over my yoga mat for extra support. Two blankets for propping or for warmth, a bolster, two blocks, and you might even like to have an eye pillow or a face cloth to lay over the eyes. We are going to be in these shapes anywhere from 5 to 10 or more minutes, and the idea is to prop yourself up as much as possible so you can find deep rest and relaxation. Let's begin in a reclined goddess pose. So to build our first shape, we'll take our two blocks. We'll place one at the back of the mat at its tallest height, and then the next block a little bit closer to you on its mid-height. And then laying your bolster over those blocks. It might take just a little bit to find a spot where the blocks won't fall over. And then turning yourself around. So your lower back is just at the base of the bolster. We'll take our blankets and fold them up enough so that we have support underneath our knees. So we'll take the soles of the feet together, and as the knees fall out, we'll prop them with the blankets. So we don't want a lot of stretching or sensation through the inner thighs. So by building the knees up, you can allow that whole area to relax. And then allowing yourself to lay back on the bolster. You might like to reach for your eye pillow and just resting that over the eyes. And then just allowing your hands and arms to rest anywhere that's comfortable along your side. You might have your palms facing down, palms facing up. You might even feel most comfortable if you take your hands and rest them on your belly or your abdomen. And it might take a little bit of time to wiggle around. Allow yourself to settle in. Allowing your belly and your hips to feel really soft and open. Allowing your breath to move freely in and out of your nose. Noticing where your body makes contact with the bolster, the floor, and the blankets. And then allowing those areas to feel even heavier, sinking down into the support. Allowing your mind to shift from going and doing to just being. Nowhere to go and nothing to do. Start to bring our awareness back to the breath. Elongating the inhale and the exhale. We'll take our time to move into a seated position, just bringing the eye pillow off to the side. You could keep your eyes closed if you like, pressing your hands into the earth, moving your blankets just a little bit off to the side so you can cross the legs. And sitting up with a tall spine, we'll take one hand over our heart, one hand onto our lower belly. Before we move into our next shape, we'll just take a few moments to acknowledge what we're feeling in the lower body. What we're feeling in our heart space. Not labeling it as good or bad. Just noticing, observing. And just allowing the hands to come down onto your legs, take a deep inhale and exhale, sigh it out. Our next shape is a supported child's pose. So we'll take our two blocks to the front of the mat and you can choose the height of the blocks that you need to create some space underneath the bolster for your arms to go. So for me, I like the blocks about mid-height, but others, you know, you might like it on the middle part here. It's also gonna bring the bolster a little bit higher up. So if you have more sensitive knees, there won't be as much pressure on them. You're welcome to take your blanket and roll it up. It can feel nice between your bum and your heels or between your ankles in the floor, especially if you get cramping in through your feet. The second blanket might feel really nice to lay over your lower back. and we're going to crawl our way up towards the bolster. And you might want to come right up and lay your belly onto the bolster. If your abdomen is really bloated and sore, you might back yourself up a little bit so then your belly can hang off the back of the bolster. And I'll let you know as we come down when we're midway so you can turn your head in the other direction. We're about halfway if you'd like to turn your head in the other direction. very gently start to transition out of this supported child's pose by bringing the weight into your hands, starting to roll up through the spine. When you get to the top, just moving any blankets off to the side, shifting the weight of the hips to one side, and then just extending the legs out long in front of you. And we'll just move our bolster and blocks to the side. We'll just take some gentle movement here by leaning back onto the hands, bending the knees, bringing the feet a little bit wider than hip distance, and then just letting the knees fall from side to side. And we'll set up for our last shape, basic relaxation pose. We'll take our bolster. We'll place it near the front of the mat, just so eventually it's in a spot where our knees can rest on top, our legs on top of the bolster. We'll take our blocks and just place them on either side of the mat in case we want to rest our palms on the blocks. Have your eye pillow close by. And we'll take one blanket, the back of the mat, and we'll create a little bit of support for the head and the neck. So you can get creative with whatever shape of blanket that you have, but having it folded a few times, and then you could bring a little bit of a roll into it for the curve of your neck. So just kind of wiggling around. And then with your extra blanket, you could place that over your abdomen, or maybe you place the blanket over your entire body. Setting up your eye pillow. And then your palms, they might reach for the block and rest face down on them. If that's not comfortable, you could just have your hands resting on the earth. Taking a moment to scan the body from head to toe. Maybe you can feel your heartbeat in your fingertips. your heartbeat in your toes. The subtle rise and fall of the belly as you breathe. Allowing your eyelids to feel heavy on the eyes. And the eyes heavy in their sockets. All the muscles of your face relax. The muscles of the jaw soften. The tongue falling away from the roof of your mouth as the teeth gently part. Giving the body and the mind permission to fully relax. Start to bring awareness back into the body by moving your fingers and toes. Roll out through the wrists and the ankles. Bend your knees. Bring your feet onto your bolster. And then gently draw the knees in towards your chest. Slowly rocking side to side, massaging the lower back into the earth. Rolling onto your most comfortable side, landing in a fetal shape for a few moments. Using your top hand to help press you all the way up. And we'll close our practice together. Seated. Let's take one hand onto our heart again and one hand onto our belly. Closing the eyes or having a soft gaze somewhere on the floor. Feeling the rise and fall of the hands as you breathe in and breathe out. Once again, acknowledging how you're feeling physically and emotionally. Bringing your palms together now at your heart, humbling the chin. Thank you so much for sharing your restorative yoga practice with me. Remember, regardless of what you're going through or how you're feeling, you're not alone. Namaste.